Hello everyone, welcome back to the second short albums review video. In this one we're going to cover albums from February 2019, which the list is way bigger than the one from January. So if you have seen the previous video, you know the drill. It's about these albums that I didn't feel like making a full review out of them, just spending 5 or 10 minutes talking about them, and I decided to just share a few thoughts with my ratings on the albums and just not let them get unmentioned. Scores usually go from 6 plus to 4 minus, and some of these albums I do recommend for you because they might be more to your liking, and there are others that I just don't. With that being said, let's get into the albums. Boys from Panda Bear. The reason I didn't make a full review about this album is because I'm not really a big fan of Panda Bear's music anyways, or even his input in Animal Collective, which in my opinion is one of the most overrated bands I can think of. Though I can give that some of the previous Panda Bear albums had some few appealing moments to them. In this album, they're completely gone. From having some of the most obnoxious vocals I've ever heard in a Panda Bear album, filled with reverb and other effects, being way too loud in the mix, and a folktronica sound that I'm not a fan of, and I don't think it's well executed in any way. The album is just a 4 minus out of 10. It's a bad album in my opinion. This debut from Nivek is one of the projects from Grouper, which with that being said, I looked forward to this album because I enjoy some of the previous Grouper releases, even though I wasn't a big fan of Grid of Points, her last album. And when the album starts, it starts really strong in my opinion. The first two tracks have some interesting, drony and more intense moments to them. Kinda sounds like an old school Grouper. Even though the whole structure of the songs was a bit off-putting, with being only 4 tracks and each one being separated in different parts, which don't have that much of a cohesion between them and you can just sense when the next song is going to play, I was really underwhelmed with the second half because, as it seems, it just repeats moments from the first songs and I couldn't see why. It takes some of the more underwhelming and more uninteresting synthy sounds from what did not appeal to the previous tracks and just makes a bigger mess. And I don't know why the album ended up feeling so poorly executed, especially on the second half. I really liked some of the parts of the first songs, and then it ended up like a lost potential. It's an album I ended up being a little disappointed with it. So it's just going to be a 5 out of 10 for me. The new Health album, it's okay. It has some of the heavy and industrial moments that are well executed, though production in the most part feels a bit madder than what I would want. I think that few of the songs would be much better if they would sound more rich and well textured in sound. But other than that, it's a decent album with a nice sort of cyberpunk aesthetic to it. Even though I enjoyed it, I didn't see myself coming back to it for more, but it's an album I do recommend you to check out, and I'll give it a 6 plus out of 10. The new album from Vanum goes to the atmospheric black metal sound I would expect from them, maybe too much of what I would expect to them because it feels like something I've heard before, done better. I don't think it offers something more to the genre than another just decent release. It has its moments, production is nice, performances are really good, but it's a bit of a forgettable album that didn't really click me, but I do recommend you to check out if you're fans of atmospheric black metal sound in particular. It's a 6 out of 10 for me. One album that I saw more potential out of it though was the new project from one-man band Saor. And the first song is actually great. It has all the elements that I love from an atmospheric black metal song. It's a bit unfortunate that as the songs progress, there is a bit of a lack of that much of new ideas or originality. And even though I like the inclusion of Celtic folk music, having the entire last song to be just that for about 5 minutes, it wasn't the best way for me to finish this album, and it ended up leaving me in a cliffhanger wanting more out of it. But at least I can see it being in my honorable mentions of the year, because it's a nice and decent atmospheric black metal release. It's a 6 plus out of 10 for me. And now we go to the most underwhelming side of black metal music with this new release from Rotting Christ. I haven't been that much of a huge fan of Rotting Christ music, the more melodic approach on black metal music. I don't think it works that well, but I could at least appreciate it for its raw energy. But Rotting Christ is a band that has blown up in the black metal scene tremendously. And since they're that much of a popular band and they're able to have such a well-produced album, they end up coming with albums like this. Not only does it not complement the sound of the previous Rotting Christ releases, it's not memorable whatsoever. It's an album that it feels you've heard from Rotting Christ multiple times before, done better, and this is one of the most generic examples of black metal music I can think of currently. It's such an underwhelming release, it's actually kind of sad. I end up giving a 4 plus out of 10 on this. It's that underwhelming in my opinion. Out of the 3 Mikos solo releases, Father of Four by Offset is the most personal one, and it seems to be the one to be the most diverse, the one with some interesting features and some more intriguing parts in the instrumentation and the production standpoint. Other than that is your typical commercial sound that you've heard so much of Migos, to the point where it gets really annoying and they have nothing more to offer than their standard delivery. Like, the flows are the same, the delivery is the same, and even if it's the best out of 3, it doesn't really say that much, because it still suffers from some of the elements that make the previous 2 solo albums extremely generic and underwhelming. Father of Four is a 4 minus out of 10. I was kind of expecting the new Night Lovell album, because he's one of those cloud rap artists that I was seeing a bit of potential, and I thought some of his previous stuff were decent. And the starting point of this album is actually really good and really intriguing, but it's such a shame that the album is so one-dimensional, it's so boring, it's so criminally repetitive that it's like absurd. The album gets so boring so fast, to the point where you don't even care after a while, because you know you're going to hear the same thing over and over. The delivery, the beats, like even the mood, the melodies, like everything seems so deja vu. It's like it's playing the same thing. And it's really unfortunate, because I had hopes for this album, but it's even way more disappointing than what I would have expected. So this is just going to be a 4 plus out of 10 for me. Same with the new release from Forbidden Society. It has a really solid start with some really intriguing drum and bass songs from an artist who is known to deliver some solid drum and bass material. But the issue with this album is not that it gets one-dimensional, but my issue is that it quickly loses character. The album doesn't know where to go and how to progress. And some of the later tracks that go into a bit of a more dubstep oriented and downtempo sound, with even some elements of hip hop in some tracks, it really disconnects the entire thing and it just goes downhill from there. There are some really good moments, but I was honestly expecting a bit more than just a few decent moments. This album is going to be a 6- out of 10. And the last one I'm going to mention is the new album from Dream Theater, Distance Over Time. To be honest with you, I'm not the hugest fan of Dream Theater, but I cannot deny their importance in the progressive metal scene, releasing some of the most legendary albums to be known in the history of prog music, like Images and Words and Metropolis Part 2. But it got apparent that in their later releases, they just can't make as good albums as they used to be. Their sparkle feels to be a bit gone, and so as a result we have albums like The Astonishing back in 2016, which was considered a major disappointment for a lot of fans. This new album from Dream Theater seems to go into a bit of a better direction, but the main issue is that it doesn't even sound like a Dream Theater album. It sounds like it's an album from a totally different band. There are some nice moments where they show that they still got it, like S2N for example. That is an impressive track, that was a really solid track. But there are others where it feels that they try way too hard to just push a prog sound to the point where it sounds obnoxious. Biggest example, the last track, Pale Blue Dot. And through this whole mess, we just end up with a forgettable release. The new Dream Theater album is a 5 out of 10 for me.
Also, one last mention on the new Mod Selector album called Who Else, which is just a decent electronic techno album. It's nothing that special, it's just okay, it's a decent album. It's short in length with lots of different ideas. Some of them work, others don't, like biggest example, the track Wealth with Floyo, like what is that? Like, what is that? And of course, the biggest highlight of the album is Who with Tommy Cash, like, big fucking surprise. And so, yeah, this is just a 6 out of 10 for me, nothing else.
And these are the short reviews, some of my thoughts about few of the albums that were released in February 2019. What were your opinions of these albums? If you've heard them, like them, dislike them, why? And what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.